In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you, my brothers and sisters. In today's gospel, the Lord Jesus shows to us his divine providence and his loving wisdom, so that we might place our faith and our trust in the Lord. Let us begin this Mass by first calling to mind our sins and then asking the Lord for his divine mercy. Lord, for the times that we have not placed our faith and our trust in you, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, for the times that we have forgotten your loving presence within our lives, Christ, have mercy. And Lord, for the times that we have not lived truly and fully the gift of our faith, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us our sins, and may he bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Pardon the faults of your servants, we pray, O Lord, that we who cannot please you by our own deeds may be saved through the intercession of the mother of your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
I will turn their mourning into joy. I will console
God has risen in our midst, and God has visited his people.
Alleluia, alleluia. May the Lord be with you. Our gospel reading is taken from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. At that time, Jesus withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a Canaanite woman of that district came and called out, "Have pity on me, Lord, son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But he did not say a word in answer to her. His disciples came and asked him, "Send her away, for she keeps calling out after us." He said in reply, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But the woman came and did him homage, saying, "Lord, help me." He said in reply, "It is not right to take the food of the children and throw it to the dog." She said, "Please, Lord, for even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the table of their master." Then Jesus said to her in reply, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed from that hour. The Gospel of the Lord. Amen. Notice in today's Gospel, the Lord Jesus seems to be downright rude to this poor Canaanite woman. Why would he do something like that? Well, first of all, let's stop and let's fill in the details. Remember, being Canaanite, she was not Jewish. She was obviously a pagan. And of course, being a pagan, she would have known very little about the one true God. Even though she comes to Jesus and does him homage and pleads with him to heal her daughter, the problem was she knew very little, if anything, about the one true God. She certainly did not have the religious background to understand that Jesus could be the long-awaited Messiah. So notice what Jesus does is he gives the woman time. He gives her time to develop the gift of perseverance, and through his dialogue with her, gives her the opportunity to develop the gift of faith. I mean, the dialogue in today's gospel actually only covers a couple of verses, but chances are, in actual time, Christ Jesus spent a good bit of time with this woman, teaching her about the one true God and teaching her about God's loving mercy. It was only after that that she came to understand the one true God, God's love for her, God's love for her daughter, God's loving power at work. Only then did he grant her wish. In other words, notice, Jesus' main goal was not simply to give her what she wanted. Jesus' main goal was to give her what she truly needed, namely, the gift of faith. Notice in our own lives, Almighty God does not always give to us that which we want or that which we think we need. Almighty God does not always give us what we want, how we want it, when we want it. But what we can place our faith and our trust in is that Almighty God will give to us that which we truly need, whether we know to ask for it or not. Almighty God's main goal in life is not simply to please us. His main goal in life is to lead us to his heavenly kingdom. And he will see to it that we receive everything that we need in order to complete that journey. So that we might place our faith and our trust in Almighty God's divine providence, let us now present to him our prayers and our petitions. That we, reading the scriptures and looking at our own lives, might recognize the loving wisdom of Almighty God at work, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that we might place our faith and our trust in God's divine providence, we pray to the Lord. That we might ever answer the Lord's call to us, we pray to the Lord. For the special intentions requested for this morning's Mass of Lynn Mead, for the special intention of Chad and Nancy Villavasso on this, their 26th wedding anniversary, for our own individual intentions, as well as our personal prayers of thanksgiving, we pray to the Lord. Loving God, you bless us with your divine providence. You seek to draw us ever closer to you and ever closer to your kingdom. Grant our prayers and our petitions, so that ever living as your people, we might accept the eternal life that you give us in Christ Jesus our Lord. Blessed to you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Pray, brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Let us pray. Receive, O Lord, we ask, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offering, that through the intercession of Blessed Mary, the Mother of God, no petition may go unanswered, no request be made in vain, through Christ our Lord. And may the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You may have noticed in your missalettes or word among us, today we celebrate the feast of Saint Mary Major. This actually refers to this ancient church in Rome that was built shortly after the Council of Ephesus way back in 431 AD. It was at that council that it was clearly defined that Mary's child, Christ Jesus, was not simply a human being, but was actually the divine Son of God. To emphasize the fact of Mary, Mother of God, that huge church was built. And that's why to this day we celebrate not so much the church building itself, but rather the feast that it emphasizes, the fact that Mary is indeed the mother of God's divine Son. We pray that that same divine Son who became incarnate through the Blessed Virgin Mary will now become Eucharistically present to each of us by changing our gifts of bread and wine into his own body and blood. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." If we place our faith and our trust in Almighty God's divine wisdom, then let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint John the Evangelist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, who enables us to place our faith and our trust in his divine wisdom. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I would invite those of you who are viewing at home and are unable to receive the Holy Eucharist sacramentally to now join me in the prayer of spiritual communion. Most Holy Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. May I never be parted from you. Amen. And let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech, O Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary may, by imitating her, serve worthily the mystery of our redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.